So we've made it to the Canries Primary School and things are looking very, very well down here. Organized lines, persons, the lines are flowing, the police officers are having no issues. So the Canries Primary School station looks like it's very, very well organized. The rains are still falling, but persons are still coming in. Persons are respecting the 100 yards mark off. They're stopping up at the top. They're making sure that their names are registered, and then they're coming trickling down into the school. I'm going to get an interview with one of the officials from the electoral office who is supervising the elections here at the Canries Primary School.
Okay, my name is Cosmas Reeves Lawrence. I am an assistant election clerk at the Ansari Canries Electoral District. I have been assigned to the G4 division, that is at the Canries Primary School, where there are 6 polling stations. Okay, if you don't mind, I will give you the number of people who have voted so far. There are about 465. And the voting process started fairly smoothly. Everybody was waiting at the beginning of the process. And so far, the presiding officers have been doing a great job, ensuring that they do it in a very professional, business-like manner. The policemen have been very helpful. And I do not anticipate any serious problem, except that, you know, there'll be more people coming in as the time goes by. Yeah. A few anomalies that we have had to deal with. For example, we've got to check for people whose names are not on the register list. We had to call the electoral department to verify, and we have been able to do that quite successfully. I think everybody generally has been quite satisfied with how things have gone, and I think we are not disenfranchising anybody. We try our best to facilitate the exercise here.
Yeah. Do you think the rains have kept persons home, or they're still coming out in their numbers despite the weather?
Yeah, I would imagine if the weather holds up, there will be a lot more people coming. Maybe in the morning when it was a bit, the rain was a little heavier, probably people might have had doubts about coming. But I think right now they would make it. I think the Canries people would really want to come out to exercise their rights as a voter.
And this figure that you've given me here, it's, let's say it's almost 12.
Yes.
Do you think that's average for this time in the morning?
For Canries, I wouldn't be able to tell you exactly, because that's the first time I'm working in the Canries division. But I imagine that, like I said, as time goes by, a lot more people will come in the afternoon. Once the weather doesn't, you know, prevent that kind of turnout.
And do you have the number of persons that is expected or is registered to vote here?
Well, I didn't take that down, but all I took was the number of persons who have voted so far. But every polling station has a number. You know, on the average, about 400 people per station. So I have 6. So if you multiply 400 by 6, about 2,400. I would imagine something like that.
So I managed to catch up with the 2016 Idea Award winner. Idea of the Year Award winner from the Chamber of Commerce Awards, Mr. Amatas Edwards. And your idea is most suited to what we're witnessing here today.
Absolutely.
It was the electronic voting system. And you just called me out and you pointed out some observations. So tell us exactly what you were telling me.
Yes. I've come here to vote, and there are about almost 100 folks line up on the polling station C to G, and that is where I vote. And I've not been able to vote, and it's moving at crawl speed. But there are 3 other polling stations that are empty, because there's nobody whose name falls under that list to be voting there. And there we see the inefficiency of this paper balloting system. With the electronic voting system, that long line would have been divided equally among all 5 polling stations, making the throughput much larger, and people would have gotten in and out of there much quicker. So apart from the benefits of not having rejected ballots with our system, there is also the benefit of efficient queuing, you know, and people are getting frustrated on the line there. And I mean, you have a line of about 100 people, 5 polling stations divided by 5, that's about 20 a line. Those people would have been out already, because our system takes roughly about a minute per person.
Right.
You know?
I am observing some people are going in and coming out a lot faster than others are.
Absolutely, because the dexterity of some different from that of others. So you see some taking a longer time. But with our system, our queues are based on dexterity of the voter. So the first queue closest to the gate would have been reserved for people with disabilities, the elderly, the slower people, and you would have increased the pace. That's right. Based on dexterity, you would have allotted individuals down to the other lines. That would have made it much quicker to get people through.
Now, are you surprised, having won the Idea of the Year award from the Chamber of Commerce, that you were not approached to at least try out your system in maybe at least one polling station come this general election?
We thought with every strategy that we could have. We had demos around the island to interest the authorities, but that didn't change anything. From what I'm gathering, they jumped to their own conclusions about the system. They assumed it was complex. They assumed it required internet connection. They assumed that if there's a power failure, it would not have been functional. They assumed that people would have been able to use it. It would be too complex for the users to use. And all of those were assumptions that could have been clarified only if they had given us a chance to make a presentation to them.
Okay, so you didn't have that opportunity to make a presentation.
We did not have that opportunity. We got this flat rejection letter without even getting a chance to present it. And that was the sad part of it. We have no difficulty being rejected. Okay, governments take decisions based on many reasons that are probably beyond me, but at least you give us a chance. I mean, after winning that award, it means that there are other sections of our community that have valued that innovation and believe that it would make some difference to our social fabric. But
I guess next year or next 4 years.
The next commission that is appointed will find our proposal before them as a first order of business.
Keep trying, and maybe the next general election we'll see electronic voting instead of pencil and paper.
Absolutely.
And well, now you need to go join your line. I've taken
you
off your line.
That is correct.
So
that
I
is
hope you make it through some time. Before lunch, maybe.
Yes, hopefully.
All right, take care. Thank you very much. There you have it, guys. I'm still trying to get as much people as I can. I was lucky enough to get Mr. Edwards, who did actually come up with the electronic voting system, and he won the Idea of Award from the Chamber of Commerce Awards in the 2016 or 2015 awards. So I'm going to go on to another polling station and see who I can catch up with. There's a lot more from the Ancillary Canneries constituency.